This video is going to be about word problems that are solved with quadratic equations. So here's the first example. The product of two positive consecutive integers is 5 more than 3 times the larger. Find the integers. Okay, so the first step is let's make sure we understand the words. Product, of course, means what you get when you multiply two quantities, two numbers. Consecutive integers. Okay, integers are whole numbers like 9, 10, 11, and 12. And consecutive means one comes after the other. So 9 and 10 would be consecutive integers. 27 and 28 would be consecutive integers. So what we're going to do is we're going to call the first integer x. And the second integer, since they're consecutive, would be one more. So that would be x plus 1. And then let's see what it says about them. We have the product of two consecutive positive integers. So the product of these two numbers, these two integers, would be x times x plus 1. And then it says it's 5 more than 3 times the larger. Well, the larger one is x plus 1. So 3 times the larger one would be 3 times x plus 1. And then we have that is. It is 5 more than 3 times. So let's put an equality sign here, an equal sign. And it says the product is 5 more than this, than 3 times the larger. So we'd have to add 5 to this to make them equal. Okay, let's clean this up. Let's do all the multiplication we need to. So x times x plus 1 is going to be x squared plus x. 3 times x plus 1 is 3x plus 3. And then we're still adding the 5. And now we've got the squared here. So we're going to have a quadratic equation. And we'll get all the terms on the left side and set everything equal to 0. So I've got x squared. And I guess I want to subtract 3x from both sides. So that'll give me x squared minus 2x equals, well, over here I have 3 and a 5 equals 8. And I'll subtract the 8 from both sides. And now I've got x squared minus 2x minus 8 equals 0. So this is just a straightforward quadratic equation. I'll factor it. Since I've got an x squared, I know both of my binomials will begin with an x. So let's see. I've got a negative sign before the middle term and before the last term, which means I'm going to have one positive sign and one negative sign. My third term is an 8, so I could make an 8 with a 1 in it, 1 times 8, or 2 times 4. 2 times 4 would be good, because when I subtract one from the other, I'll get this 2. So here's the 4, here's the 2, and I want negative 4 and positive 2. Since my middle term is negative, I'm going to give that to that negative sign to the larger of the two numbers. So I've got x minus 4 times x plus 2 equals 0. I'll set both of these equal to 0. And then I'm going to find out that x equals 4 or x equals negative 2. Well, going back to the problem, I was asked to find positive consecutive integers. So I can't use that negative 2. So x equals 4, and that means that x plus 1 would equal 5. So my integers are 4 and 5. Let's go back to the problem and make sure that works. The product of two consecutive positive integers, well, the product of 4 and 5 is 20, is 5 more than 3 times the larger. The larger one was 5. 3 times 5 is 15. And 5 more than that is 20. So this answer is going to work. Okay, let's look at another one. The width of a rectangle is 5 feet less than its length. Find the dimensions of the rectangle if the area is 84 square feet. Okay, let's draw a little picture. And it says the width is 5 feet less than the length. So let's call this side the length. And we'll call this the width. And if the width is 5 feet less than the length, then instead of having another letter, instead of having the W, I can just call the width equals the length minus 5, because it's 5 feet less than the length. And then it tells me the area is 84. Now, we want to remember that the area is the length times the width. The area of any rectangle is length times width. So if I multiply the length times the width, the length is L, and the width is L minus 5, I should get 84. Let's see. So L times L minus 5 equals 84. I'll distribute this L. So I've got L squared minus 5L equals 84. I'll make this into the whole thing into a quadratic equation with all the terms on the left. So I guess I want to subtract 84 from both sides. And I'll get L squared minus 5L minus 84 equals 0. And I want to factor that. So let's see what I've got. I've got a negative sign in the middle and a negative sign before the third term. So I'm going to have one positive and one negative number. I want them to multiply to 84. And I want the difference to be 5. So 84 is, it's 1 times 84 or 2 times 42. I can keep thinking through until I get to 7 and 12. 7 times 12 is 84. And since the middle term is negative, I'm going to use a negative sign for the bigger of those two numbers, for the 12. So I've got L plus 7 times L minus 12 equals 0. I'll set both of those equal to 0. So if I've got L plus 7 equals 0, L would have to equal negative 7. Now that's not going to work because I can't have a side that's a negative length. But the other one, L minus 12 equals 0, means that L equals 12. Okay, so if the length, let's go back to the original problem. If the length is 12, then the width, which was 5 less than the length, or 5 less than 12, is 7. 7 times 12 is 84. So now I've got my dimensions. The length is 12 and the width is 7. Okay, so that's it for these two. I'm going to do another video after this where I deal with what's called projectile problems. And we'll take care of those then. Okay, see you soon.